Cece and Romeo, Monday through Saturday from 5:30 to 10 a.m. on 93.5
KDAY. It's KDAY Morning Show. Yes, Cece and Romeo. What up, LA? It goes down in the AM, and it goes down too on this major podcast.
I love it.
Off.
Yes.
Terrell Owens, Matthew Hatchette, T.O.
That's right.
Hatchette in the building.
Yes, sir.
Cece, I'm walking him down the hallway, and like this. T.O. is so competitive.
I love it.
Because he played in the Power 106 All-Star game before years ago. Now we do it with KDAY. We would love for you to come out. Hatch said he would want to play. And what do you have to say about that?
But you guys don't even know anything about this game.
But they don't have to know anything.
Hold on.
We're not going to start this whole conversation off with you don't know about Hatch's game. They don't have to know.
If you were nice, they would even invite you out.
They haven't even seen me.
You haven't even been on their top 100 list.
Damn!
And to bring up top 100, whose top 100 list are you not on?
I'm still the greatest. It doesn't matter.
That's my point.
I'm still the greatest.
So am I.
I have worked to support what I'm saying right now.
You don't. They just haven't seen it.
Let him talk to you like that.
Exactly.
This how y'all do it?
This is how we do it.
I love
it. I got a great story. 2003, 17 years. Super Bowl was in San Diego. Tampa Bay Raiders.
Okay.
San Diego State. You played in a celebrity basketball game. I'm on your team. I got a little Bob Wall to my left. I got Nick Cannon, who does Power 106 on my right. Now, we heard you could play.
Mm.
So T.O. shoots some jumpers, and then he went and dunked on somebody. I was like, oh, shit.
Exactly. Y'all playing for real now. That's what he said.
Yeah, I was like, yo, because there were some ballers out there, but you shut them down pretty quick.
Why did you not
do two sports, man, at one time?
I should have.
Deion did it?
We've already discussed this. I'm probably like one of the best athletes that the world doesn't really know about.
I just threw up in my mouth.
That's
a horrible.
I'm just saying.
No, you're not.
That's the coronavirus you got in your mouth. That ain't got nothing to do with throwing up in your mouth.
I'm tuning in to the podcast.
Exactly.
Hey, y'all don't even need no guests on y'all show.
Right?
Yes. We love the podcast, though. Getcha Popcorn Ready podcast. We have a fun time. We go back and forth. We banter and all that. But, of course, bringing the guest in makes it, you know, funner. And, you know, they get to kind of get into the banter as well. And, again, we shoot at the guests, too, sometimes. So it's, you know, everybody's game.
Have any of your guests ever been like gotten a little upset about it? You're like, oh, they're good.
No.
Yeah,
no. Honestly, they're surprised at the banter, and it's encouraging. And so again, it's a relaxed atmosphere.
Yeah.
So
right.
That's what they really don't know, especially about me. It's like I'm pretty witty. I'm funny.
Nobody said you're witty.
We've known each other for like 15 plus years. I mean, obviously, there's the perception behind me as a football player, but this is how I act anyway. You know what I mean? Around my friends.
No, I love that you're very competitive though, because I feel like it brings everybody up. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And it makes them up on their level, you know?
Yeah. Well, even when it does that, he still doesn't come up to our level.
What do you mean?
You're just taking these L's today.
No, I'm not taking no L's. Wait, hold on. Look here, little mama. I ain't taking no L's. First of all, let's get that right now.
She sees where the needle is swaying. You know what I mean? She sees where the needle is moving.
No. Did you ever get that phrase like patent or something, dog? Like every time someone says it, you should be getting a check. It is now, right?
What's that?
Get your popcorn ready podcast.
Yeah, absolutely.
I'm great to say.
No doubt. I've had to send a couple of cease and desist.
Okay.
Yeah.
You gonna send one to me too?
Yeah.
You can't.
Yeah.
You can't now.
Yeah.
So look, man, I'm glad y'all here today because, of course, free agency is right around the corner. Everyone's talking about Tom Brady. Mm-hmm. Where do you guys think he's really going to go for real?
Well, we're having this discussion every single day for the last month.
I mean, it's
and I'm just trying to save him of his embarrassment of stop saying the comments he was making, because he was trying to say the Cowboys, which makes no sense, and he sounds dumb when he say it.
If they can get him for a year or two,
I know what y'all saying, but that's not gonna happen because you're not gonna sacrifice. The next 10 years of your organization. And that's what they're doing right now. They're going to lock him in. Worst case scenario, he'll be a free agent, like I said, in 2 years. But they're going to lock him in right now for 1 year, $33 million, I think, a year.
Who are you talking about?
On the tag for Dak.
Dak.
So he's not going anywhere. Therefore, Tom cannot go there.
Okay.
They haven't even signed him.
But Dak ain't even agreed to that yet. That's the problem.
But he can't go anywhere else. You have to agree or sit out. So
what
if you sit out, they pay you.
Yeah.
That's the only two choices you have, right? So again, in, so that Tom's not going there. Tom's coming to L.A. because Giselle wants to be in L.A.
Right.
He just opened the movie company.
They can't have seats. They need that.
And it's the best roster that's available for him to go to. That roster's better than the New England Pages roster.
Titans pretty good. They keep Henry.
Not better than that roster, though.
Mm. Look, man. San Francisco out of the question?
Out of the question because they have a quarterback. You can't go somewhere and
Brady would love to have him move out of there.
As you said, you have an organization like the Cowboys.
And you know about them.
Who has an owner. If you think about baseball and what the Yankees and Steinbrenner and what he's done, he's basically gone out over the years and bought championships. Right now, Jerry Jones wants to win a championship.
You can't buy championships in football,
though.
Yeah, you
can.
That's the difference.
Well, yeah, you can.
No, the highest
paid. Who says you can't? I guarantee you somebody said that some years ago. You can't buy championships in baseball.
And what the best teams with the most free agents have never had. But in baseball, that's never happened in football. That's never happened in football.
That doesn't mean you say it can't ever happen.
It ain't going to happen this year.
Right now, Dak has not been signed. If he was such a solid
He's a lock, but he ain't even gotten paid.
If he was Tony Romo, if he was another color, he probably would have already gotten paid.
Maybe that's the problem.
That's the problem.
And you know Jerry Jones. You know the organization. I think they would cut the check if Tom Brady would come there.
Absolutely.
I really do.
You can't do it. If he were to come there, but he can't come
First
there because
all,
there's another
said it,
quarterback
I said
there.
It before. Anybody said it.
And you sound crazy as they sound.
Guess what? Colin Cowherd has basically said this, came out, echoed the same thing that I said. Now everybody's jumping on the bandwagon. Oh, this could be a good thing.
And he sounds like a clown, too, saying he's going to Dallas. That's
crazy.
Well, look, if he doesn't go to Dallas, he needs to come to L.A. I think the Chargers definitely need that to sell some tickets. Mm-hmm. But I still don't know if that's the greatest fit for him.
What do you think is a good fit for him?
There's definitely a need.
I would say Raiders because that's my squad. But that's me being selfish.
Here's the problem with the Raiders scenario, right? He can't go. He doesn't want to go there because it's going to take too long to win.
Right,
that's
I get
the
it.
Only catch. Tom Brady don't have five more years.
Why? What do you mean it's going to take too long to win?
Look at the roster. It's just they're not ready.
Look at the rosters that he's played with in New England. There wasn't any major roster.
Yes, they have. And you also have a
coach. You can't even name two receivers from the New England roster last year.
From last year, right? They still had Edelman, right? Then they brought in Josh.
Josh didn't even play.
He played eight games.
He played eight games.
Then they released him.
He wasn't even a factor.
They didn't go to the Super Bowl neither last year.
I think Titans or Chargers. If you had to go somewhere, I don't know if Titans are the right
city. But here's the problem with the Titans scenario.
Right.
You can't sign Henry. That's the catch. And Tom Brady's not going to go there and not have my running back behind me who just, you know, is the MVP of that team. Yeah. So if you go to the Titans, then they can't sign Henry. So why go to the Titans?
Mm. And again,
you see what I'm saying?
Who has been the MVP running back of the New England Patriots the last 5 years?
Nobody, but that's the reason he would want to go.
You don't need a major back.
Yeah, that's
okay.
True.
Well, let's find out. I tell you what, we're going to make a bet.
You don't need a major back.
I understand why people tune into the podcast.
Yep, get your popcorn ready, baby.
I'm just watching. It's so entertaining.
And I'm always right on the podcast. So, you know, it's entertaining and I'm always right. There you go.
So you always win when it comes to challenges. He's always right.
He's always right or says it. That doesn't mean I'm wrong.
that's a whole nother discussion.
I'm just saying.
T.O. and Hatch hanging out with us. The CBA, is it going to pass? Is it going to go through?
It should.
Would y'all vote for it?
I wouldn't. I wouldn't.
This is the one time the players are being cheated in this situation.
They've been cheating since
1901, whenever the NFL started. I think I made this statement before. If they don't get what they want in this CBA contract, it's over.
It's a wrap.
NFL will start trending downhill fast.
Because the major thing, I think, if you look at over the last 4 or 5 years, especially not even longer than that, you have Major League Baseball and you have the NBA. They have guaranteed contracts. I mean, hundreds of millions of dollars.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And you have these football players playing our game. They're seeing this money being distributed.
Mm-hmm.
And they're tweeting about the money that they're getting. That should be a priority for these guys to get guaranteed contracts. They're over there talking about extending a game, extending a season, another one game.
They don't even make it through 16
$250,000. Are you crazy?
But I thought they were saying if they exceed 16 games or maybe even get to 18, the players can have
more money.
No, but have to take a game off or two games off.
Do you really believe that? They setting them up for failure.
I feel like, and I'm probably the least qualified, but I feel like if you're playing, you should get paid. Right. No matter what.
Facts.
Because in football, you're hurting your body. Yeah, you know what I mean? There's a lot.
There's a lot of risk.
And you're putting a lot of risk.
Don't say you're not qualified, because as a football player, these players, they have girlfriends, they have wives.
Who understand where
they're
coming from.
And they have mothers. You know what I mean? So you're part of, women are part of the equation too. It's a family thing. Mm-hmm. So at the end of the day, you're looking for longevity. Mm-hmm. It's not about right now. These owners, that's what they're looking for, longevity. Because at the end of the day, these players are going to be gone. They can negotiate this deal. Those players are going to be gone. Yeah. Guess who's still going to be there? Yeah. Those owners.
Yeah.
They're the ones going to be still pocketing that money.
Yep, mm-hmm. I agree.
So they have to look at the bigger picture. Some of the veterans, they see it, and now they just have to educate these younger guys. The Richard Shermans, the Russell Wilsons, the J.J. Watts, the Drew Breeses, the Aaron Rodgers. They've been coming out, and they've been very voiceful as far as what their decisions are and what they think should happen.
Mm-hmm. And again, not just the guaranteed money. Again, that lifetime health benefits is a huge one. And again, a 23-year-old might not, you know, appreciate that, but trust me, right now the way our bodies feel, and we can't just go get taken care of anytime we want for no price, and baseball and NBA have that, it's ridiculous.
Lifetime.
Because our bodies are way worse.
How the NFL doesn't have that, like, you know, exactly. the most popular sport and most
physical sport,
right?
Yes.
We're not going to take care of our bodies.
This is what the NFLPA, the union, DeMar Schmidt, this is what they need to be negotiating.
Right.
They're worried about the wrong thing, talking about extending the season, things of that nature. Mm-mm. Yeah, if all these other things are at the forefront, then yeah, we can entertain that. Mm. But health insurance, guaranteed contract, that should be the number one and two options.
Okay. I know. They lucky they have some when you're playing, because when you got them braces, you was playing, you lucky.
Let me tell you,
you'd still be looking ugly.
These players don't know it. 5 years after they stop playing, their insurance is cut. It's done.
Done.
Then you can file for 18 months of an extension. That's it.
Those are
bad insurance.
That's it. I mean, and listen, the injuries can last you a lifetime.
They get worse as you go. Trust
Absolutely.
Me.
Okay, so I have a question. Is Tony Romo a better sports reporter or quarterback?
Let you
I would say
that,
sports
buddy.
Reporter.
But you said he was your QB.
Okay.
You were passionate about that.
That was at that time.
But definitely, okay, well, he never got to the Super Bowl.
Exactly. I mean,
he never won a playoff game.
And that's the thing, is like, he's reporting, he's calling the games, but he's not taking any hits. So that's what, as a quarterback, that's what he's taught. That's his job, is to survey, dissect the defense. So that's basically what he's doing when he's talking. He's basically
from film study.
Yeah, from, just film, from study. Film study. That's all he's doing, is just letting you guys into the quarterback's mind of what they do on an everyday basis.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
And really, receivers, running backs, anybody in that film room, we're looking at the same thing.
Exactly.
We can break it down
doing a great job of articulating.
He really is.
Yep.
But
you know what I mean?
The money he about to make is
ridiculous.
Crazy.
It's all. I'm happy for him. Yeah. Like, again, it helps other players look at, you know, when they get done playing football and there's a career after, he can make a large amount of money, which is great.
Right.
Yeah, I'm shocked. But again, as far as him,
I'm not.
I'm shocked. I mean, comparing it though,
it's
crazy.
So you're shocked. Why are you not shocked?
Yeah, why are you not shocked?
Because it's the same reason why Dak hasn't gotten paid.
Mm.
So you're saying Jerry Jones controlling the sports media as far as Detroit
Aikens? I'm sure
Aikens
that probably
all,
has
got a lot
to
do
with
it.
I'm sure it does.
Okay. We know it does, yeah.
Receivers played the game. Antonio Brown, should he be grinding back into the league? Or what the hell's wrong with him? Anybody talk to this dude?
I'm good. I'm friends with him. I think he's making some steps to kind of change some things.
Because he's
a dope-ass player.
He,
I mean, they should definitely, you know, obviously – every man deserves a second chance.
Or will this be his third chance? That's the catch. Because what I'm saying, like, you can't just say, I want to be back in the league when you've had a track record like you have and not proven that you've fixed yourself.
Right.
And, and so he's got 6 months to fix himself.
Right. So
basically,
I think that's the process in which he's, you know, under right now. He's
Favorite rumors is Tom Brady said he would like to play with him. I know it's out there. What if that's true? If Brady comes to the charge and say he has to come with me,
it'll never happen. The Chargers. The Chargers are not an organization like that. They will not bring in Antonio Brown.
But
Anthony Lynn does not play that.
And
the ownership.
Play, but sign him
but,
too.
Right. But
he's not.
Tom,
he doesn't have that
Tom
power.
Tom Brady has right that now. Type of influence.
See, he's saying he doesn't.
Because not with the LA Chargers organization.
He doesn't matter.
That's a, again, when you're talking about ownership That's different. That ownership. Now the Raiders.
But if
different.
They're trying to win,
I guarantee that.
Yeah. If the Raiders would matter, if he's trying to win and Tom Brady feels like he can come in and help them, they will consider it.
They will consider it. And
if I'm an owner, I know I would.
There's going to be some
certain owners, certain owners don't. The Chargers ownership, they don't play that. And Anthony Lynn don't play that.
But do you understand what it do for the city excitement? Like
not
Brady
if you don't win.
Well,
you see what I'm saying? Because Antonio Brown doesn't mean you're going
Tom
to
Brady
win.
Tom Brady ain't going nowhere.
They have a better chance of them winning.
But do you know the Chargers receivers they have now?
Oh, no. That's what I'm saying.
So I'm saying that scenario is out. The Raiders, yes. He could go in there and say,
he knows the GM
I know
the
more than
hand.
You is what I'm
what
talking,
are
about.
Talking about.
The one-eyed man is king in the land of the blind. And right now, I'm the one-eyed man.
If that's the case, if he's so great at what he's articulating,
I should have a job
why,
in the NFL helping being a general manager. Because I'm helping you out.
You're not helping.
I'm helping you out. I'm helping you learn football.
What do you mean? This is Getcha Popcorn Ready with whose name first?
Hatch and T.O. They got it wrong. They got it wrong.
Whose trademark is headlining this thing? Exactly.
You know what?
Who's pulling this wagon?
Okay, Hatch, I got a question, though. Who came up with the name? It's never my fault.
Exactly.
Who came up with that?
This guy. And you know what's funny? It never is.
Oh.
It never is. But here's
the
funny about our relationship, right? Because I've seen him like deal with other people all these years. And it's funny. It's not his fault, but I'm a type of person, I don't really care about when, you know, kind of pointing the finger at people.
Mm-hmm.
But when it comes to him, they like pointing the finger
yeah,
at him.
Look at you right now.
So therefore, I appreciate him not caring that they're pointing the finger at him. Okay. And I appreciate the honesty that, you know, he kind of perceives as far as his character. You know, so that's kind of where the friendship comes along. I still don't like him right now. That's
but
my
this
guy.
This is what makes the podcast work.
Yes.
He don't give a shit.
Yeah.
He's like, this is how I feel. And you're like, you're the reason, rhyme and reason.
I'm
guy,
the only you know? One with a little bit of rhyme and reason. Absolutely.
Wow. Can you out-rap
him?
No, he can't out nothing me.
He's
nothing.
Never, he doesn't even have any bars to his name.
Do you want to go right now? You want to go live right now?
I dare y'all
go.
Come right
on, let's go.
I ain't going first.
Let's go.
I ain't going.
Go. Damn, Matthew, you got this.
Before y'all go,
exactly. Here you go. Here you go.
Come on.
Nah.
Y'all gotta give y'all one word. Rap on skills.
Skills to pay the bills. Done.
There you go.
Done. What's up?
Okay, can I ask you guys? I have to ask you for everybody watching right now. Mm-hmm. Please tell me you guys have cameras following you guys so we can actually see it because this is amazing.
So basically, every Tuesday the audio version of Getcha Popcorn Ready podcast is released, and then every Thursday the YouTube version of it comes out.
Oh, nice! So they can definitely check it out.
They can definitely check it out on YouTube and say Getcha Popcorn Ready podcast on the Himalaya app or wherever you get your podcast, and it's also Spotify, Apple, or wherever you get your podcast. Yep. Basically,
Now CC and I want to come on your podcast one day.
Absolutely.
We're gonna have a game night.
Okay,
we do that.
I've had game nights at my place. And the thing is, I win so much. I don't even really drink.
Well, I don't drink at all.
I have to find a way to lose. I have to find a way to lose.
So to make him feel better.
This is the lie he's telling. So you're saying when you drink, that's when you lose. So you can have an excuse to lose.
No.
That's a cop out, dog.
No, I'm just saying my guests feel bad because I'm always winning.
You ain't always winning.
You know what I mean? It's like, what kind of guests are you? You bring it there, you just want to see us get drunk. You know what I mean? And the only time I really do lose is like in a team situation when it's really not my fault.
We just dropped the old masterpiece song.
It ain't my fault.
I know I'm paying attention here.
Shaka up in here, man.
Gotta get y'all out to a Power 106 KDAY Celebrity All-Star Game in LA. We do schools every week for free to raise money for schools. So if you guys want to come out, I think it'd be dope.
Plenty of times.
Yeah, you definitely done it for sure. We got to get you out there. He's claiming you can't play, but we got to see
you
play.
You can play?
No, he cannot. First of all, I guarantee you.
Why are you? She was talking to me.
All you people out there, I guarantee you won't see him.
I
guarantee you won't see him.
Okay, I tell you what. Do you want to put some money on
him?
You want to put some money on him? I tell you what.
He went to the pocket.
Not see him. I'm talking about on the court playing. You may see him in the building.
shooting. What? He ain't playing.
Wow. The right side of the bench.
I tell you what, you're going to see me, see me in the corner of the three-point line busting his head. That's what you're going to see.
They've already seen me play.
I don't, nobody,
so what? It's documented.
That doesn't mean it was good. You're here.
I'm a witness. I'm a witness. I was like, this month right here to be in the league.
He was playing to get some average Joes.
Get your popcorn ready.
Who
just comes up with "Get Your Popcorn Ready" for just no reason?
I really hate that's the name of the show.
You know what I mean?
I hate it because he came up with that and I didn't have no say so in it.
I'm like, I'm creative.
And you did have a say so then.
Exactly. We tried for 2 weeks and I was just like, I can't find nothing.
Never my fault. That's what T.O. said.
It ain't my fault. Did I do that?
Yeah, let them know how they can follow y'all, man. We appreciate y'all stopping by. How they can follow you on IG and Twitter?
My Twitter is Hatch89. My Instagram is Matthew Hatchette.
Okay.
Pretty much all my social media is at Terrell Owens. And then obviously you can find me on Facebook at Terrell Owens.
Okay.
I'm not hard to find.
Right? He sure ain't. He everywhere.
Yeah. Everywhere.
When you have a high Q rating, you're not that hard to find.
Oh my God, I love
you. You know what?
You don't have.
You don't. Harry, don't say that.
You
don't
have
say that.
To really search for this guy. You have to run.
So give it your Instagram.
Hold on. Yeah, exactly. Hold on. Hey, look. What the hell are you laughing at over there?
Exactly.
You over there on this chuckle. Oh. What you doing?
You know what I'm saying?
Oh my God. I'm saying, dog.
Hey, I appreciate y'all stopping by, man.
I appreciate it for having us.
Hey, we got to do like at least 3 or 4 times a year.
Yeah, we ready. Yeah, we do a takeover and just take over the entire show. Yeah,
not a
Friday,
problem.
Friday takeover.
Yes.
Not a problem. We would love to, for sure. Get your popcorn ready podcast.